Hi, I'm Rick Edwards and I like to tweet to let people know what I'm up to and gives my stalker valuable information on my whereabouts. He's just back there. When I'm not tweeting, I use the rest of my time productively by seeing what other people are tweeting and then passing the highlights on to you. I'm like a Moira Stewart of the blogging world before she got too old. Here's what's been going down in Twitter town. One hot topic on everyone's lips at the moment is the new celebrity super couple to give Brangelina a run for their money. Katy Perry and Russell Brand, or Crussell Prand as I like to call them. It's wordplay. It's a lot of fun. Apart from Katy tweeting really immature things to Russell like, I love you, God, grow up. Fans have been whipped into a frenzy by reading between the lines of one of Katy's recent cryptic tweets and deciding that she's pregnant. I, however, have got a different theory. Hey, Rusty Rockets, I heard you're pregoed. As any well-travelled cosmopolitan TV presenter knows, the word prego in Italian actually means you're welcome. I looked it up, so that should clear up any confusion. In the words of Columbo, case closed. Now, Twitter isn't just a place to say you're welcome. It's also a place for the big names in showbiz to invite us into their curious little worlds, which I'll demonstrate in our next section, Stars Love a Good Tweet, or Slag Tweet. So I've started following star of Twins, Junior and general pint-sized living legend Danny DeVito. Not only did this man make being bald and under 5 foot extremely desirable, he's also this week proved that he's a photographic virtuoso. Seems that DeVito has been sliding his tanned foot into random pictures and then posting them up on TwitPic. Don't ask me why this is brilliant. It just is. And can I call him Tanny DeVito? I've recently tried it myself. Have a look at the results. And sadly, the tweeting world has temporarily lost its original icon, Mr. Stephen Fry, who needs time to write his new book. So I've made it my mission to scour the online world for a suitable replacement. Someone whose tweets are so genius, they'd make God himself blush with inadequacy. Someone who befits the title of King Twit II. This week, I nominate Mark Byron. Remember him? He rode the crest of the TV wave onto the paradise shores of Shipwrecked Island last year before being washed back into obscurity in sunny Crosby. Remember? No? Doesn't matter. But he's now making a name for himself as a tweeting colossus. Here's just a few examples of how this guy can speak volumes with just 140 characters. Trying to get the cat to scratch me to see if I turn into a superhero like Spider-Man, but a cat instead of spider. Great stuff, Mark. What else is troubling you? Haven't got a clue what a truffle is. I think pigs poo them or vomit them. Yeah, they definitely poo them and vomit them. If you thought that was good, check this out. What are scallops? The king is dead. Long live the king. I can't wait to see what he brings to the laptop next week. And a little clue for you, Mark, as to what a scallop is. It's what doctors use to cut you open. Like a nurse. Pass me the scallop. Got it? Scallop. If you see anything funny or weird or disturbing and you think I'd be interested in, retweet it with an @reply to T4Witter. I'll leave you with some of the pictures that you lot have sent in of your snow sculptures. Dappies never look so cool. Someone made a Dappy snowman.